people and say, oh, I'm never, you know, they take my guns, blah, 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 blah. No, you're not. You're not. Stop saying that. Just be real. You're not. Most people would hand them over. And that's the truth. And I hate to say it, but that's the truth. It's terrifying. The government is terrifying. Look at what's happened to these poor January 6 people. None of you want to be in there with them, do you? I know I don't.
Okay, so she hates to say it, that if certain guns were made illegal and the government was to come and try to get them, she hates to say that people would just turn them over. As opposed to what, Marjorie Greene? What's the alternative that you prefer because you hate the implication that they would just hand it over? This is why, like you might think that because they're profane and awful and racist and all that, that they're strong, like we conflate those things, but they're also incredibly cowardly. I have a challenge for Marjorie Greene. Tell me what you actually mean. Should they shoot the person who comes rather than hand it over? Should they be dragged away to jail? I mean, that might be one implication of what she means. The other would be that she should gun down the government official that comes. So specifically, who should they shoot? The ATF? The FBI? Is it a local cop? The National Guard? Who should these gun owners murder so that they don't have to hand over their guns specifically? How many of them should they murder? Should they shoot them in the chest? Should they shoot them in the head? You understand that they will eventually end up being either killed or brought in for murder. So I don't understand how that's supposed to be better for them. But be specific about the political violence that you'd like to have happen. If the law were to change, you believe that gun laws can never be more restrictive than they are right now. There's no legitimate way that any gun could ever be made illegal. What should be done? What should they be willing to kill 100 cops if they show up? Maybe blow up their cop cars. Where exactly should the line be drawn? She wants to make that implication that she would be stronger. You're weak. You'll hand in your guns. She would never hand in her guns. Okay, so what would you do with your gun if they were to come and get it? And of course, this is a massive dodge. There has never been anything like this. They're constantly talking about government agents coming to your house, either take your guns or stick you with a vaccine. It's a complete fantasy. It's like me talking about orcs marching on Cincinnati or something. It has as much grounding in reality, but this is the sort of stuff that they use to get their base to support them.
Yeah, and you know, it's just the absurdity of, you know, that we the people stand a chance against the mightiest military the world has ever seen in terms of technology and just how organized they are. Like you said, we're gonna shoot them when they come to their door. Like, it's like people don't realize that if the government was gonna come and take your guns or come after you, they don't even have to come shoot you. They could poison your water supply. They could shut off all of your credit cards and your bank accounts and literally lock you in your house. Anything electronic, they could just, like, they don't have to do that. Or if they were, they could just like plot some type of like, you know, come kidnap you up out your sleep type of deal. You know, they'll come in, like, that's what you're dealing with. So the idea that it's like, come take it if you want to, like, it okay, or they could literally just nuke you, or it's so stupid.
Drone strike you.
Yeah. Like, okay, so okay, good luck with that. And then obviously, like, she closed it out with the, you know, those poor people on January 6th, you know, because it should be your right to storm into the halls of the heart of the nation to defend Donald Trump, a former game show host who's a failed child who's ripped everyone off his entire life. It's so saddening. But it's so stupid. It's just so stupid, man.
I agree. You make a great point. How about this? Maybe we can have some bipartisanship here, okay? Maybe Marjorie Greene and us, maybe we can come together. Since you want a future wherein some regular people with AR-15s can fight off the US military, how about we come together and stop giving the US military so much money? Because you realize that you're arming your future enemy in this case. You're giving them the drones and the tanks and all that stuff. How about this? How about let's cut their funding and then maybe you'll have a chance. Can we work together on that?